my dear students, right now we will start session 16.4. I am Dr. Mali, and we will continue sound and waves. Lesson 1, waves and sound, or sound and waves, which is session 6, Tuesday 28th of April. Yesterday, we talked about waves, and we said that waves are disturbance in which the energy transfer or transport from one point to another. So, this is the waves, and as I said before, this is a transverse wave. And we said that the movement of particles by wave means excellent vibration. So this is transverse wave, and this is longitudinal wave or compressional wave. How to measure transverse wave? As I said, transverse wave, this is wave, wave, and wave. The wave, transverse wave, all the time is in movement. First thing, wavelength. What is wavelength? Wavelength is the distance between two waves. The distance between two waves is called wavelength. So, the height of the wave, the height of the wave is called amplitude. The height of the wave is called amplitude. Okay? What is the name of the highest point of the wave? The highest point of the transverse wave is called crest. The highest point of the transverse wave is called crest. So, what is the lowest point of the transverse wave? It's called trough. It's called trough. So, the distance between two waves is wavelength. The height of the wave is called amplitude. The highest point is called crest, and the lowest point is called trough. T-R-O-U-G-H. So, this is transverse wave. As I said, the distance between two waves is called wavelength. So, this is wavelength. The height of the wave is called amplitude. So, this from this part to this point is amplitude, and from this point to this point, this is amplitude. Okay, and as I said, from the distance between two points is wavelength. Compressional waves. We said that in compressional waves, the example of the string, you find that the particles move back and forth. Back and forth. Look. Okay, so the energy transport or energy transfer back and forth in the compressional waves. So, in the compressional waves, the area in which the particles are pushed together, the particles are pushed together, is called compression. So, the area in the compressional wave where particles are pushed together is called compression. It's called what? Compression. And the area, this part, the area in the compressional wave where the particles are spread apart or move away, is called rarefaction. It's called what? Rarefaction. Rarefaction. Okay? So, this is compressional wave. As you see, particles move, causing vibration. The area in which the particles pushed together is called compression. The particles move apart or spread apart is called rarefaction. This is a compressional wave, as we said. This is a spring of a coil. And even if the sound waves, because we said that the sound
wave are example of compression wave. You find that the area in which the particles pushed together is called compression. So here is compression, here is compression, and the area in which the particles are spread apart is called a rarefaction. Okay? And the direction of the energy wave is in this direction. The direction is in this direction. So this is longitudinal wave or compressional wave, both of them the same meaning. And as we said, the wavelength is the distance between two waves. Between two waves. So, frequency. What is frequency? We said that waves are moving, but when the waves move or pass an amount of time, the measurement of how many waves pass an amount of time is called what? Frequency. So what is frequency? It's a measure of how many waves pass in amount of time. What is the unit of measuring frequency? The unit of measuring frequency is called hertz. It's called hertz. And we can write it H capital V small hertz. What is hertz? Hertz is number of waves per second. So again, what is frequency? Frequency is a measure of how many waves pass in amount of time. And the number of waves per second, number of waves per second is hertz. And hertz is the unit of measuring frequency. We can write hertz as capital Z small. See, this is time and its unit is seconds, and the number of waves in seconds is hertz. So in this diagram, how many hertz? 5 hertz. Okay? Even frequency. Lower frequency waves. What the meaning of lower frequency waves? That means lower number of waves in amount of time. Cause less disturbance than high frequency waves. Of course, when there is smaller number of waves in amount of time, this is called lower frequency and it causes less disturbance than high frequency. Higher amplitude waves. What the meaning of higher amplitude waves? We said that amplitude is the height of wave. So, when the height of wave is high, that means, of course, which is very logic, more stronger than lower amplitude waves. Look, this is the difference between the high amplitude and low amplitude. And the frequency, which is number of waves in amount of time. So, in this picture, look at it. Said that, and this is, as we said, this is compressional wave, this is compressional wave, this is transverse wave, and this is another transverse wave. But here, it's higher frequency than this diagram. In this diagram, it's higher frequency than this diagram. So, this causes less disturbance than this diagram. Okay? Thank you so much, my beloved students, for this session. See you tomorrow in new session. Goodbye. Dr. Marie was with you.